Hi, I'm Amy Smith, and I am a Charlotte Mason homeschooler, and I'm also director with Usborne Books & More. And I want to share with you today some of the books that I love from Usborne Books & More that help my Charlotte Mason homeschooling. We all love classic literature, and Usborne Books & More has some really beautiful, unabridged, illustrated books like Black Beauty, Jungle Book, we have Anne of Green Gables, Around the World in 80 Days, Treasure Island, so many great, beautiful books with some fun illustrations in those. These are all unabridged. The Railway Children by Nesbitt is gorgeous, as well as Heidi. So many great books. We also have many books that can help your child's understanding of Shakespeare. We have our illustrated stories from Shakespeare, which I loved reading to my children as they were just getting introduced, because as we know, some of the themes can be a bit mature, but beautiful illustrations can show your child to help them become familiar with the stories. These are really lovely. Next, as your child gets older, you could introduce them to the complete Shakespeare. And these are stories from all the plays. Each story begins with a nice synopsis of the characters, and they can look at some pictures and to see who the characters are, and they can go back to see who those characters are. So that's really a nice volume. I also wanted to show you Hamlet. This is one of our graphic novels, and I'm reading this to my son right now. He loves the real Shakespearean text is in this, and it's so wonderful to just make the story come alive. He loves this. We also have a fun World of Shakespeare reference book, which shares about Elizabethan times. You can see some artwork in there, really beautifully illustrated, and some really great primary text for your child to look at there, as well as the Where's Will, where you can find William Shakespeare in his plays. So each play, here's Twelfth Night, you can find the characters in the plays, and you can try to find William Shakespeare in those fun illustrations. We always want to get our children outside, seeing nature, and we have some books that can really excite your child about that. This is 1,000 Things in Nature, which is really beautifully illustrated. You can see there's 1,000 things to see, from bugs and leaves and seeds, and they can see trees. So many beautiful things to see in that book. We also have two really beautiful uniquely shaped book, Bug Hotel. You can see the metamorphosis of a butterfly or various bugs in these lift the flaps as they can read the little bite-sized chunks of information and really enjoy seeing the earthworms, many fun bugs in Bug Hotel, as well as seeing birds in Bird House. We love both of these books, and you can see the beautiful illustrations. You can see the different nests and the eggs that these different birds have. They're really both beautifully illustrated by Clover Robin. We have some great Lift the Flap books. Usborne is, as you might know, is famous for Lift the Flap books, but we have some that will really help extend that nature time, get their juices flowing. So if you want to learn about animal habitats, this is Animal Homes, and here's some bees, and they can lift the flap and learn all about the bees. Children love lifting these flaps, and Riverside Homes, so many different things you can explore with these flaps. We have Look Inside Nature, where they're going to look inside woods and ponds and rivers, so many different little burrows, chipmunks and rabbits, so many different things that they might see in their own backyard can be in this book, as well as Seas and Oceans. If you live on a coast, or you might be going to a coast on vacation, this might be a great option for you as well. We also have just a beautiful volume of Poems from the Wetlands. This is by Eric Ode and illustrated by Ruth Harper. This is one of my favorite books. The Frog, Lily Pad Leaper, Moss Carpet Creeper, Swimmer in Slippery Skin. A beautiful rhyme for all of these gorgeous poems. I can't recommend this volume more highly as you look at the wetland inhabitants. We have nature journals. Of course, it's always important to keep a nature journal wherever you are, and a little pack of colored pencils. This is a really lovely nature journal. Some small illustrations are along the sides there, but your child can have their own notes and sketches as they explore. And this one is a stargazer's journal with this really sweet little rubber band that they can hold it closed. you can see some sketches from space and stars on that one. We also have two great books that are wonderful for learning about the woodlands and learning about outdoors. Tree Detective. So lots of things that you're going to see outside. Many ideas for activities you might want to do no matter what weather you're going to see. And the Woodland book, you can even explore more. So both of these are hardcover books with paper pages filled with many things to explore. So these don't have flaps and are slightly different than those lift-the-flap books that I showed you just a minute ago. Moving on, when your child is beginning those narrations, you may want to have a thesaurus with you. This is a first illustrated thesaurus, which is nice to have. We also have the Not Your Everyday Illustrative Thesaurus, which again has pictures in it, which can be exciting for children to find those words, as well as an illustrated grammar and punctuation. Of course, they're going to be getting some of that or most of that from their copywork and dictation, but you're going to see some really great rules and things like that. So this is a really highly researched book. So all the books from Usborne are really highly researched from, of course, Usborne Publishing in England. And here is our illustrated dictionary, which always good to have one of those in the house. Next, I wanted to highlight some of our books for the arts. We have this really beautiful first book about the orchestra. This might seem like a baby book, but it's actually really lovely. Can teach your child the different instruments in the orchestra and just a simple way to learn the instruments and have fun if you're gonna go for an outing to see an orchestra yourself. We have Lift the Flap Art, which your child can lift a flap and see the different kinds of art for modern era, going through the Baroque period, through the Renaissance period, all the way up to now the modern period. That was Lift the Flap Art. This is Lift the Flap Questions and Answers. So yes or no, can I be an artist? Yes, you probably already are one. So I'm gonna show you some books in just a second about projects that you might be able to do with your children. I love these because a lot of times our art instruction can come from YouTube or different online arts, and those are great, but I like to set one of these in front of my children and let them just explore a book rather than putting them in front of a screen. So this gives really nice step-by-step instructions on how to emulate a specific artist. So there's Georgia O'Keeffe, and then you're going to try to copy that design, making a petal collage. So a lot of different projects in this book, wonderful for getting your child interested and excited about their artwork. And even more, a complete book of art ideas. This is a spiral book, and this is really nice because it has three different books in it: art ideas, art skills, and art projects. So if you have an art lover, this is a step-by-step book that uses many different materials. You can create many different pictures, many different projects and creations with this book. And lastly, I wanted to show you three different books: Drawing Faces, Drawing Animals, and Drawing Cartoons, my son's favorite right now. So many different ideas, again, using books rather than maybe that screen instruction to teach your child how to draw. Let's jump into some consumable books. This is our Rubdown Transfer Book of Butterflies and Bugs. We also have one called The Wild Garden. And your child will take these transfers that are in this envelope in the front, and they will be able to put them on these beautiful pictures and also be able to use their colored pencils or even their watercolors to finish these beautiful pictures. We also have many origami books, and I love these. These origami sets come with a set of origami paper and origami dinosaurs with step-by-step instructions, T-Rex, really sweet. So the paper coincides with some of those. You can see the Triceratops on the front there, and origami here, beautiful papers, and the instructions are in the front of this book. This book is similar to what we have. We have many planes to fold and fly. These are great too, to get those handicrafts in, get their fine motor skills moving. For our youngest learners, because we all know when we're home, we want our preschoolers to be occupied. The Big Book of Nursery Rhymes is wonderful to get those phonemic awareness juices flowing. We love this book. We love nursery rhymes in general, and we try to read a nursery rhyme every single morning for my preschooler. We also love these fingerprint activities and rubber stamp activities. These are so great for those 3, 4, and 5-year-olds who you want to give them a nice task to do something. So they're going to create little monkey faces, or they can create little birds with these little rubber stamps and the ink that comes with this book. And same with the fingerprint activities, which is a little bit messier, so make sure you wash your hands after, but kids love them. You can make these little walruses, make some little fish with fingerprints. And lastly, for those little ones, we love these magic painting books. These are very simple. You just dip a little brush in water, and beautiful colors come out just simply with some water. So that's just a mess-free activity for you to keep some little ones occupied. So I hope you found some ideas, and you can see that there are many choices from Usborne Books & More that might be able to help your Charlotte Mason homeschooling.